Hello there, everyone, and welcome back to Napoleon Total War 3. As I remember last time, I think I left it off more or less than I should. Go ahead and auto-resolve. Now when I think about it, I think I had a naval battle going on that I was probably gonna have to do. But other than that, I don't think I was gonna move Ney just yet over to attack the Austrians. So I think it's just the naval battle where we want to attack this Ottoman navy, which actually sunk my smaller navy. Let's see, we have quite a clear advantage, but with the naval battles, I always feel as though the AI has a tendency just to get the ships sunk, and we haven't done a really good naval battle in a while, so let's go ahead and do it first. I'm just going to go ahead and autosave. Now, I haven't really experienced any crashes in a long time, but I still want to make sure. Fire! We're able to see the cannon crews fire through it here. The enemy ship should be out here somewhere. And one-eyed McJoe standing here. Standing by. He's half asleep. I only need one eye, sir. There's the Turk. Oh, no! I don't care. The guy's clearly a bastard. Right, full speed ahead. We'll keep it at this view. It would have been nice. They're about to roll out the guns. And we're about to fire upon the Turk. Go on then. There we go. Oh, and the firing up from there as well. No! We had a marine fall dead over there. He's standing right on his face. Oh, we can see a little Turk up there. There's one climbing. And he made it. We're coming really close here. No, not that. Just hold the ship. The enemy is taking a lot of fire. And he did surrender. Yes! Very good! End the battle. Heroic victory. Yeah, we'll put chips on the front side this time around. But I don't think I will show you the entire naval battle, because that was way too long and way too messy. Ah, a prize ship. We will take it, because we have lost some ships. And then you will move to repair the fleet before we can take on any more. Oh! The Sardinians are trading with Great Britain and the Russians. They're breaking our blockade. No! Bastards. We will have to redraw. And that means that I lose money. The Austrians are pulling more troops to the bridge. So we're gonna have to attack the bridge. There is nothing for it, really. And there are more Russians running about. Saxony. The Swedes. Swedish Navy. The Mecklenburgs. The Hessians. The Danish are on my side. So I don't have to worry about the Danish. Unless they betray me like the Turks did. And the Spanish. The Spanish have a lot of armies. If they betrayed me, that would throw everything off course. I actually noticed, I don't think I made point that out in any of the others, but the Spanish did take Gibraltar. They have taken that. Agent detected. And then agent recruited. So we have another agent over here. We're going to see about moving him towards this location. Trade route raided. Not very nice. General available. Recruitment report. A lot of troops are being recruited. A lot of roads are done. And factories, musket manufactory, and farms. Right, this one was gonna go and check what's in Budapest. We have a wounded army, was it looks like. Well, there's two armies there. Seems like an ample target for Napoleon and his force. But I think next one is to move these two armies, these two army groups forward to deal with the guys on the bridge and open up for an attack. While these two armies will move forwards towards the border here. Can I close off, maybe, the escape route of the enemy? And then we'll have the cavalry go to the forest. And the spy will move up. Shouldn't you be hiding? Seem to have quite a lot there. And that's the annoying sound. This town seems to be fine, and it's probably gonna keep being fine. And then we have this army, but it's not gonna be, it's not really strong enough. So we're waiting for reinforcements down from here. So he's gonna actually move back before moving forwards. Where were you going? Over there. And then we have the troops that were recruited. These two to move forwards together with these men. We had some grenadiers as well, I believe, somewhere. Ah, here. Yes, they will come with the rest of these, or with the cannons and stuff, because we have a load of troops being recruited here as well. How about some of those light troops for Napoleon? Some of them guards. Cavalry, I need none, I don't think. And just more fusiliers. But this force will continue forwards. Am I recruiting anything here? I don't know, I can't. We have a lot of money that I can spend, but I'll do that in the end. What we need now is a land battle, I think. And what better way than to see the enemy off the bridge? And they were forced off. Then, as someone commented, the correct pronunciation of... I called him Lannes. It's the French way of pronouncing it would be just to pronounce it as Lannes. So Jean Lannes, but that sounds a bit weird, so maybe I'll just call him Lannes. You know, the hero, Lannes, from the last battle, or Ney. Will Ney press the attack? Or Lannes? I want the guard marines to sort of make up for the last time. And this is quite a small force. So let's have Lannes attack him. He's going to get reinforcement though from the town. But we're gonna sort of not use them. Right, so let's go ahead and autosave. Just in case. And then fight the battle of Prerov Mines. And it's Gustav Gerverius that is the enemy commander. But he's a low ranking one, he's not a general. And his order was to hold the bridge. He probably would have done better just to hold the bridge rather than fall back from it. They have their units up there. Let's move our cannons to point. And we'll have our fusiliers strung out along there. We'll have the guards over here. And the grenadiers. And then we have the light infantry. They will move up in front and skirmish in front of them. Heavy cavalry will take this side, while the light cavalry will take this side and move around the village. And then the general himself will be posted right there. And we're off. First up, move these into skirmish formation in front and move forwards. The enemy has come under fire. And it's time, I think, to advance. Let's move forwards. Fusiliers, advance. Guard marines, advance. And the grenadiers will be held back as reserve. While the reinforcements will be held back. What, you were... I guess there was an enemy hiding there. Jaeger Company. See if the Fusiliers can move into... The Voltigeirs can move to deal with the Jaeger Company. So we'll have them move a bit more like this. In this way. While the Fusiliers will move through this forested area. Like so. And then you will move into this area. And then the cavalry can move to deal with the Jaegers up there. And the Marines are marching forwards. This cavalry is marching through there. You will halt. Marines, halt. Return fire. Oh, it was actually a grenadier unit. And here's another... it's not actually grenadiers. Not sure why I called them grenadiers. Voltigeirs not doing so hot. They've lost 50 men. Ah, we have two units moving here. Two reserve units. Let's see if we can... they've formed into line. Let's move off. This... Oh, crap. Why have you lost so many? Fall back immediately. They're under attack by the Jaegers, and they have been slaughtered by the Jaegers. Holy crap. Carabiniers, I want you to move fast around that. You need to move around like so. the deadliness of battles is still something I'm not really used to, which I'm gonna have to change around the way in which I play it. Just through that little that they moved, I guess, through the fire of the Jaegers. The Jaegers are really bloody powerful in this. They slaughtered this unit, took 150 men out of it. These two are holding on fine, but they're losing men. We need the cavalry to come in. We're gonna need the reinforcements here. We need the cavalry to come in over here. Damn, the Jaegers have range, don't they? They're able to fire at this range. And they're slaughtering the cavalry. Go ahead and charge them then. Damn. Holy crap. This cavalry's coming back. Here they come. The thing about how the Napoleon Total War 3 mod normally is that you could actually do bayonet, charges. They were actually useful. While in this one, they become entirely obsolete just because of the way the superior firepower of every unit. So they become utterly useless. It becomes completely useless to bayonet charge, unless you find yourself in a situation where we're gonna need cavalry support over there. Turn the cavalry around. When they move, that's when we can get them. Oh, don't go that way. Go this way. Now charge them. You have to contact them before they fire, because you cannot withstand it. And then we can hope that the cavalry should be done by then. Now, just said the bayonet charges was useless, and then I sort of did a successful bayonet charge. But that could have turned out very badly if they weren't supported. We lost a ton of men throughout this. And I'm gonna tell the cannon to hold fire. Jaeger companies is something... Before, they weren't really that much of a problem. Now, they're like murder machines. There's no one that kills as many of my men as the Jaeger companies. We need to push. Everyone has a Jaeger company. Every country needs to be destroyed. How is the French Empire not fielding any rifled musket is going to be able to fight all of these bastards? And we want to make sure that these Jaegers don't come back. It seems that my cavalry charge here might not turn out too well. Yeah, they're fatigued. I'm not sure if they're going to be able to squash this unit. They're only going to be able to squash it if they manage to get through. They're about to give way, though, the enemy. Oh, crap. The Guard Marine is getting slaughtered by fire in the back by this unit. It's certainly a lot quicker with this submod Didn't I tell you to bloody well charge? Go ahead and charge then. And why are you not able to break this unit? Charge through it.
The men are fatigued, sir, and must rest a while.
These guys are in square. Enemy general is killed. One of these. Yes. You will continue. And you will ride up and shoot that square and break it. While you will charge over there. The reinforcements were definitely needed. Now I'm lucky that they actually did not choose to defend at the bridge. Because that could have been really horrible. Imagine going over such a point, having to go through such a point, and having the Jaeger companies on the other side of the river just cutting you down. Cavalry seeming to have quite the difficulty in chasing down these bloody Jaegers. Speed it up. Go on, cut them to shreds. And everyone else has managed to get to their post. Right, these guys are gone. We're just gonna continue a bit and shoot at them as they retreat. Wow, they didn't hit jack shit. Well, let's go ahead and end the battle, shall we? Close victory. Not very good. Yes. Well, clearly it's gonna take a while before I'm used to this kind of... The last one I did went well, but this one... I mean, I don't think I've ever lost as many men as this. I almost lost 1,000 men. This unit was reduced to 90 men. Yes. You're gonna have to move up there. You're not able to make it back, are you? No. Okay, so these two groups are gonna have to do their attack on this next time around. But that's not gonna be for this episode. We're gonna need a lot more troops. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed it, and hopefully I'll see you guys for the next one. Bye!